I am back on YouTube. Yay! People have been requesting for me to post on YouTube again. I've been on live and so many people also have DM'd me to get back on YouTube. But I'm back. I feel better than ever, I guess. I don't know. But anyways, in today's video, we're gonna do a clean girl look, which I've been doing a lot recently because I have been so lazy with my makeup. But yeah, that's the only reason why I've been doing clean girl looks, even though my nails are not very clean girl-esque vibe because they're very baddie, and I know they're very overgrown and disgusting. I haven't had the time to get my nails done because I have been kind of busy, to be honest. The reason why I've been not filming on YouTube a lot is because I have been busy with TikTok brand deals, focusing on that because, girl, I have contracts, and if I don't do them, I get sued. So let's finally start the video. And before I ever do anything, I like to spray on perfume. It really sets the tone, it really sets the vibe that you're going for. Here are some of my favorite clean scents, but first is this one. I just bought this like a month ago. This is Degree Dior. I've smelled the body wash of this and I loved it, so I got the perfume version. And I only use this, to be honest, before bed or if I'm doing a clean girl look, but I usually wear this to bed. This one I really like. This is Springtime in a Park, and this is from Maison Margiela. It's very fruity, floral, and light on the nose. That's why I love this, and it smells very clean and fresh, and it's just very like delicate, very girly. I would also recommend this one. This is Beach Walk from Maison Margiela as well. I'm clearly a huge fan of Maison Margiela. They just have the best selection for fragrance in my opinion. But this is Beach Walk. It's very salty and it smells like your skin after you went tan on the beach. It's not really a clean girl scent, but you could like squeeze it into the clean girl category. Next one, this is a very clean scent. This is Tom Dow from Diptyque. It's more of a male fragrance in my opinion, but again, you could use whatever. But it's a very woody, spicy, but light, very, very light fragrance. This one is more of a glam type. You can squeeze it into the clean girl category because I know a lot of clean girls also use this fragrance. And this is from Chanel. This is the Chanel Gabrielle, and or Gabriel, or however the fuck you want to pronounce it. But yeah, this is like one of my favorite perfumes, but it's very like strong. You only need like a couple sprays, and this is just the essence version. Like imagine the Eau de Parfum version, but like the essence version itself, it's very strong. This is just some of my perfumes, by the way, not all, but here are just like the clean girl, what I would consider a clean girl perfume, obviously. Anyways, like I said, before I start my makeup or anything, I like to spray a perfume to set the tone or set the vibe. I'm using Springtime in a Park, and I just love this. Spray this on my hair as well because I love spraying my perfumes on my hair, on the wrist. And don't rub your wrist, just like tap it. And I am just gonna do my hair. I'm gonna show you guys how I do my slick back hair. Honestly, all you need is got to be glued spray. This is gonna be easy for me because my hair is already straight because it's literally a wig. What I find works the best for a slick back is the Tangle Teaser. Trust me, this will make your life easier. If you're working with your natural hair, go with the Got To Be Glued styling gel for edges, and then you could lock it in with this. But with the wig, you could just use Got To Be Glued. I have like 5 of these. Like, I still have one right there. I have 3 of this unopened and unused yet because it's just the best ever. Elastics and a claw clip. I like to use 2 elastics. These are the best elastics, to be honest. This is from Miniso, and I've been using them for the past year, and I still have a little bit left. I like to go right here, and I roughly only get this section from the front. You don't have to separate this piece, by the way. Just go up and like that. Okay, it's gonna get messy at the back, and just like brush that out. After that, I like to like pull out like the sideburn piece, but it like looks a lot better than just not having anything on there. Hold my hair in place and then spray. to look it back. I'm just gonna tie it with the elastic, put it up in a claw clip, and then I'm gonna be right back. A slick back bun is so hard to do always because, like, girl, that took longer than expected. But I just changed out my jewelry. Now I'm just wearing my Bottega mini drop earring. I saw this on Hailey Bieber. For clean girl, you always have to wear gold jewelry. They're such a gold jewelry girly, and I currently have my silver love bangle screwed on, so I don't want to, like, unscrew them and then screw a gold one. So we're just gonna have to have silver jewelry. So before I do my skincare or do anything on my face, while my face is still, like, freshly washed, not have any, like, skincare on them, I like to do my brows because I love laminating my brows, and if there's product, usually my brows don't stick. But I just have the Get Ready With Me brow lifts. This is the OG brow lift max, which is broken because I don't know why their packaging always breaks. So this is the brow lift pro. I like using the brow lift max a lot, but this is literally the same as the OG. So having a clean laminated brow gives off a very clean look. But again, other clean girls prefer having fluffier brows, which I don't mind them, but, like, girl, I love laminating my brows. I really like to take my time to shape this so that I don't need to fill them in that much because my brows already have a really nice natural shape to it. But some days my brows are, like, very cooperative, and, like, some days they're just, like, they're, like, stubborn as hell. So they're still, like, wet, so we're gonna wait for it to dry and then it's gonna set matte. But while waiting for it to dry, I'm gonna do my skincare, which is a very important step before any makeup look, but especially a clean girl look, because we want our skin to be glowy, hydrated, and just, like, yummy. First, I go in with a toner. This is the Clinique Clarifying Lotion. This is the number 2. This is an exfoliating toner, and this really helps my chin area. And, like, I always got crusty right here, so I just more right here. I like to, like, use my hands and just, like, tap it in. Then I use 4 different moisturizers. It's so excessive, but it helps me, and this just helps keep my skin glowy. And this is my second tub. This is the Cintiq 5x Ceramide Barrier Repair Moisture Gel, and I've done ads for this brand, and their brand is just so good. Not, this video is not sponsored whatsoever. I've been loving and enjoying their products. And then next is the Olay Hyaluron. This is their niacinamide. I'm just going to apply that right there. I don't use a serum because this has niacinamide and hyaluronic acid, so I don't really need a hyaluronic acid and niacinamide serum. Next is the Oxycure Ultra Gentle Moisturizer. I don't know, I just like using this. I use this much and just rub it in. And then I saw Jelly Eugenio use the Sunnies Dream Cream. This was actually sent to me by Sunnies, and I just use the Dream Cream whenever I do my makeup. I don't really incorporate this in my actual skincare routine, but I just use this whenever I'm doing makeup. Gives an amazing, like, glowy, like, glass skin effect. The dogs! The dogs! Anyways, for eye cream, I'm using the Olay Hyaluron. Using the Charlotte Tilbury Setting Spray, I like using this before I apply my foundation. I don't know, it's just a habit. But this is my 3rd bottle, and this is just, like, the best setting spray ever. I'm using the Dior Forever foundation. I'm telling you, this foundation would last me the entire day, and it is, like, so oil controlling. But you have to know how to use it, because it does get cakey if you don't know how to use it, and you don't know how much to apply and, like, how fast this sets as well. You have to work fast. Yeah, this is just, like, my favorite whole grail ever. Like, I use this all the time whenever I go out. By the way, I'm in the shade 2.5W. I should have gotten the N, because I've just realized that I have a cool undertone, you know. By the way, if you're wondering where I got my brush, this is from the Happy Skin x Marge collab. I went to the mall and then I just saw this, and I was like, I'm not gonna not buy this, because again, it's gonna be sold out probably, and it's gonna be hard to buy this, so I just decided to buy it. I love Marge. I've been following each other for, like, quite a long time now, to be honest, and I really enjoy her content. She's just, like, so calming. She just has a really nice aura and energy, as well as Kai Javier. Favorite. So entertaining, so funny. She's just the funniest and the sweetest person ever. DM'd her a couple times, I think, and we interact mostly on the comment section. But honestly, can't wait to meet my fellow content creators in real life. And I know they've been telling me to move to Manila or, like, visit Manila or whatever, but I'm just like, the anxiety of living home, you know, and just like moving to another city and just like not know anyone is just so scary to me. Like, what if something happens? What if there's an emergency? What if I like go broke? Like, girl, what am I gonna do? Anyways, for concealer again with the Dior, because I love Dior. This is the Dior Forever Skincare Concealer. I like this better than the Backstage line. I don't know. It's just a preference. Plus the Backstage line leaks all the time. Like the packaging leaks. I have there the shade 3N and 1W. I'm gonna use a 3N to color correct.
Oh my god, I'm literally the worst. I just saw that I didn't record the part where I put on my bronzer, but for my bronzer I used the L Halo Glow Wand in the shade Medium Bronze, and as well as I also used the Dior Forever Skin Correct Concealer in the shade 3N under my eye, and then on this part to color correct first before applying the light concealer, which you guys are gonna see in the next clip that I'm already blending out.
Okay, now I'm gonna blend out my concealer, and I like to really like go very gentle with my concealer and just like keep it where I want to focus the highlight, because if you drag it out too much, it's just gonna blend too much and we're gonna lose the purpose of highlighting our under eye. See how that just like lifts and brightens the face? This is turning into a very glam look, but like at the same time, that's just how I like to do my clean girly look. I like to really bring my concealers right here so that my blush has a base and it doesn't look like it just like mushes with the bronzer. I hate that. You could use whatever blush you want, go straight to powder blush, but I like to do a cream first and then powder on top. This is the Patrick Ta Double Take Cream and Powder Blush, and this is my favorite blush ever. This is in the shade She's That Girl, and I have been using this nonstop. But Get Ready With Me Cosmetics just sent their entire Milk Tint line, like the new ones, so I think I'm gonna use that instead and just use the blush of the, like the powder of this. And again, they sent me the entire line, like literally. I've been on the Get Ready With Me PR list for quite a while, and I'm just like so lucky because they just give out the best. But I think I'm gonna use the shade Fruit Tea, make it different, because I always use pink blushes and this is a red blush. I'm just gonna apply it right here, right here. These are pigmented, but they blend really well. Using this brush to blend it out. Oh my god, it's so pigmented. We're gonna fix that in a bit, but it's so pigmented. Blend this out as much as I can because this is just like looking crazy. Okay, I was able to tone that down a bit, but we're gonna powder. Girl, I was talking so much and it wasn't recording. But anyways, I just applied the Patrick Ta blush and just like the tiniest bit setting the cream, and also did my powder bronzer just a little bit, and also did my eyeshadow, which I just used bronzer and just like did that, and then I brightened my under eyes with the Sunnies powder. I also filled in my brows a little bit, just like the sparse area. I didn't really like fill them in, if you could see. I just like went in with a pen and just like filled them in, and I don't know why it wasn't recording, girl. Anyways, moving on. Now it's either we do a wing liner or not. It just depends on you. I will not do a wing liner. Bit of the same powdered bronzer from Get Ready With Me. I'm just gonna run this across my lower lash line. We're looking a bit powdery, to be honest. So we're gonna, again, melt it with a setting spray. Okay, now see how we're just like glowy, but we're set in place, you know? Like the makeup is not going anywhere, but we're set, we're glowy. We're looking like a clean girl meets glam. Okay, now for lashes, I'm just gonna curl them. I'm gonna use the Polish Curl Supreme. This is it compared to the, like the normal curler. It's more flat and it could lay flat against your eye. Catches every single hair up until here, and you don't have to worry about like moving it or whatever. But yeah, loving this. Recently, I gave one to my mom because I have a spare, so I just gave it to her. I'm just gonna curl my lashes. See how it gets like literally every single like eyelash hair. Okay, for mascara, I have here the Get Ready With Me mascaras. Honestly, this is a buildable formula. I like my mascaras to be just like, you know, just one coat and it's gonna be just like, you know, amazing. But you have to build this one up, and this is good for beginners or just like, you know, people who just like don't want a clumpy mascara situation. And this is perfect for clean girl makeup because we don't want clumpy eyelashes. So the pink one is the volumizing and lifting mascara, And then this gold one is the lengthening and lifting mascara. And then like this bronzy color is the mascara primer. So I'm first gonna go in with the mascara primer. And this is what the wand looks like. And it's like tinted blue, but it doesn't really show up as blue. And it has like little fibers in them to help with the volume and like the length. So I'm just gonna go in with this first. And when I apply my mascara, I like to go up and out from the root to the tip. And going outwards, because that just gonna help with the cat eye look, even though we're not wearing any eyeliner. I was scared to use this because like the primer, because I'm afraid to get it in my eye and it's just gonna irritate my eye, you know. And like, okay, I spoke too soon. It kind of went in my eye and now my eye is like feeling, oh my god, what the fuck. Okay, I spoke too soon. The fiber went into my eye and had to apply eye drops. That's fun. I think I'm gonna use the lengthening and lifting mascara. I don't know how many coats I'm gonna do. Probably just one because I already have the primer on. Those are the lashes. Honestly, they low-key eat and they slay. I just tightlined with a black liner on top and now going in with a nude one. The pencils that I use are from Tevia. This is their eye intensifiers in the shade Cold. And the one I'm using like right now is in the shade Flesh. This just helps open up and elongate the eye. You're fucking kidding me right now. I just finished my look and I wasn't recording. Again, what I did was I lined my lips with the Get Ready With Me lip liner. This is in the shade Cali. And I just lined my lips as I normally would. And then for my lips, I use this. This is the Get Ready With Me High Beam Lip Oil in the shade Baby Girl. And I just apply this all over. And then I set again with the Charlotte Tilbury setting spray. And then a dewy setting spray from Get Ready With Me. This is their dewy fixing spray. And that's about it. But yeah, this is the finished makeup look. And I am honestly obsessed and in love with this look. It just looks so glowy. Looks like I have healthy, glowy, bronzy skin. But I honestly am wearing a lot of makeup. But it still looks clean. It still has the clean girl vibe. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about this look. Comment, like, subscribe, share this video. I don't know. I know I've been off YouTube yet again, and I can't promise to be consistent because I can never be consistent on YouTube. There's always so many things going on in my life that I cannot just, you know, but I'm gonna try, okay? I'm gonna try. I have 2 terabytes and that's a lot of storage, to be honest, for YouTube. So I think I'm gonna try to utilize that as much as I can. But yeah, that's all for today's video. Let me know what you guys think about this look, if you like it, if you're gonna recreate it. If you think I'm wearing excessive amounts of makeup for a clean girl look, I don't know. It's your opinion, but let me know. But yeah, that's all. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.